Dr. Peter Kreeft joins us now, and he's familiar to Catholic TV viewers from his previous appearances. Today he joins us to talk about his book, which I have right here, Wisdoms from the Psalms, which focuses on some of the dozen popular psalms. Doctor, thank you so much for being with us today again on This Is the Day.
You're welcome. Thank you for having me.
Well, the Psalms have become a part of common parlance, almost an Old Testament version of a tweet, but they really go deeper. Why do you think the Psalms are so appealing to people?
Well, because God inspired them. They're the only prayer book we have that comes directly from divine inspiration. And they're songs as well as prayers. They're like sheet music. You have to pray them aloud on your own piano, playing them on your soul, so to speak. And they're powerful. They work.
And there are a lot of psalms, and I was wondering how you decided which psalms to focus on in the book.
Well, I find that my head doesn't usually work unless my heart pumps blood into it. So these are the 12 psalms that my heart loves the most, and I assume that most people feel the same way.
Yeah. What? Okay, so you knew we were going to ask this, because they always ask this when you write a book on a certain subject. What's your favorite psalm, and why?
Oh, well, as a sinner, Psalm 51, which is a great psalm of repentance, and as somebody who loves God, Psalm 42, as the heart pants after the water brooks, and as a philosopher, Psalm 1, which is the profound philosophy of the two ways, and as somebody who's like the Beatles, in need of help, my favorite word, 23rd Psalm, the Lord is my shepherd, in other words, all of them. I got four kids, and they once asked me together, which one of us do you love the most? And I said to each of them one by one, you, and you. And they understood that.
To talk about the Psalms in particular for our faith lives, if you could, and especially during this time of year, the season of Advent, how they can help us in our spiritual life and preparing for Christmas.
Well, they're not a kind of spiritual technology. They're not a machine that gives you guaranteed results. They're like life and like love. Stuff that's guaranteed is kind of boring, useful and safe, but boring. The Psalms are surprising. They're much more than they seem. They're like the ocean. They seem simple and clear on the surface, and they go down and down, and you keep going down farther and finding more weird-looking fish down there somewhere. It's just a kind of a try it, you'll like it thing. They're guaranteed to be much more than they seem.
And how would you recommend that someone maybe who is unfamiliar with the Psalms read this book?
Well, I think the way to read a book is the same as the way to tell a story. In Alice in Wonderland, Alice has fallen into Wonderland and she's kind of confused, and the Red Queen says, "Tell me your story, my child." And Alice says, "I don't know how to tell a story." And the Red Queen says, "Why, it's as simple as pie, my child. You just must remember three things. One, begin at the beginning. Two, proceed until you come to the end. Three, then stop." So that's the way to read any book. The order in which you read them is not terribly important, but just do them. That's the secret of prayer, not how to do them. That's of secondary importance, but just do it.
Now, I'm always interested in the process of why someone chooses a topic to write a book, and Wisdom from the Psalms, what made you decide to tackle the Psalms?
I've learned a lot from them, and as a teacher, I want to share what I've learned. So here's genuine wisdom. It's a gift of God, and I want to pass it on. I'm like somebody in a long relay race, and here's the baton. I want to hand it to other people. Hey, look at this.
Yeah, I've noticed, too, that when you read the Bible, there are parts of the Bible that are more difficult to read, and yet the Psalms, I think, hit everyone right in the heart. Do you find that people connect more with the Psalms sometimes just because they tell almost a story about how we should live our lives?
Yeah, every aspect of life is in the Psalms. They're simple and honest and clear and, if you will, primitive. Nothing terribly sophisticated about them. Everybody relates to them. They're from universal human experiences, everything from the top to the bottom.
Well, Doctor, thank you so much for being with us. Wisdom from the Psalms. Where can people find a copy of the book?
Ignatius Press or Amazon.com.
Well, always a pleasure having you on. Thank you for all you do, and have a great day, and stay safe.
You too. God bless you and your work.
Thank you so much.